After 9 hours of grueling hiking, three mostly out of shape, hamburger-eating Americans finally made it up Surprise Canyon and to the Panamint Hilton at 9:30 p.m., April 11, 2008. For a few hours, we thrashed about wildly in the last spring, only to fatigue ourselves on the steady, gradient climb to the top. Two sidewinders, four burros, and one Panamint rattler later, we saw the looming phallus that is the smelting chimney, a dark silhouette against a vaguely lighter background. After seeing this cabin, similarly silhouetted, remember, this was nighttime, our hopes instantly ignited.
Man, we... We scored, basically. We finally made it. 9 hours of hiking, 4 miles, whatever it is, and there just happens to be a cabin up here.
Look at
it. Way better than this sounded, like they said it was on the internet. I mean, there's
Are those
everything.
More?
There's propane tanks, there's batteries, bottles, chairs, beds. It's like a real furnished cabin, except for there's no electricity and gas or whatever.
What are we going to start with? All right, this is the morning after. Here we are in Panamint City, and Ben's going to give us a tour of the Panamint Hilton.
Yes, this cabin is definitely much more than we expected when we arrived last night. Considering we were all very sore.
Here we have a nice little balcony. We can just kind of chill.
Yeah, this thing is definitely equipped. Notice the first aid station on there, which exactly was it was what it was. I'm sorry, when we came in, and this thing is like, I mean, fully loaded. It's got beds and tools and first aid everywhere. It even had a hanging, it had a hanging plastic, whatever you call that,
food storage.
Yeah, food container. Storage bin, which is cool, and. You can see people left a lot of alcohol bottles up here. There's guest books, lots of history of people coming, all logs and books, and lots of good reading material.
Yeah, we're reading the logs. They're pretty funny.
But people left, like, basically all the stuff they didn't want to carry back down. That's what it looks like. Like, oh, let's donate it to the cabin. And
yep, there's, like, sleeping bags.
Sleeping bag, yep.
A two-piece rain suit.
Check this out over here.
A tent. And then some dude... named, what's his name? Leonard John Herschel. He's a member of Panamint City, huh?
Check this out over here. This is a wood burning stove, and then you can just cook stuff on the top, which we did last night, which is.
Yes.
We're gonna go look for wood in a little bit. Nice, was this a queen size bed?
It's a queen size bed, it's nice and comfortable. And then they have a bathroom.
And the bathroom, yes. Shower. Maybe when they fix the water again, you have running water for the shower. Because the water works, it just, you know, toilet. All right. Go.
For those of you concerned about us firing guns in, you know, this is a nice area that we don't want to deface, and we are totally about that. This area happens to be just a big trash dump that we found just beside that little tiny mountain over there. A little hill. So all we're doing is shooting the stuff we got out back into there. We know there's no people around. It's all good.
Hey, loosen your tripod.
Okay, ready? Now watch this drive. No, I'm just kidding. Somebody say good shot.
George.
Look at the bottles. You see the bottles?
Yeah, I got you.
Get it?
Oh, that was just a shell that just landed on my neck.
Did you get it?
Yeah, you didn't.
You didn't hit anything.
You blow, dude.
Hey, let me get a shot. Watch, I'll bet you I'll get it in the first shot. Go.
The last rusted can is going to be shot by Andrew Perry.
There was actually a delay, dude.
It hit it and then...
It was gone in 18 1875, so they had to start making it way before 1875. Probably back about 1850 or something, it started up there. It was going to take them at least 20 years to build a town.
Yeah.
And they were mining silver up there. This is a silver mine. And then the whole city got wiped out in about 1877, you know, flash flood.
All right.
And they say there was like 500 people killed.
Wow. All right.
And they never found nothing of them.
Thanks.
And because there's a lot of people, you know, they had tent cities all the way down the canyon. People lived in the canyon, you know, in tents. And it happened at night, they say, about 2 in the morning or something like that, and everybody's asleep, and the wall of water was coming right down on the top of them, wiping them all out.
Oh, man.
Rejoice and be glad, for the springtime has come. We can throw down our shovels and go on the bum.
What can I do for you, Jim?
Hallelujah.
Welcome to Panamint.
Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. The springtime has come, and I'm just out of jail.
Yeah, if you look at some of them, they're still sleeping bags over there. Right here, there's still sleeping bags in that one, aren't there?
Hallelujah, bum again. Okay. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. I went to a house and I rapped on the door. And the lady says, bum, bum, you've been here before.
All right, we found this cabin up here.
Hallelujah,
check it out.
Bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again.
Oh, it's furnished also. Nice.
I
got
like
a guest book,
Hill.
Too.
He's
oh,
a
my goodness.
Friend of mine.
Dustin!
Why I
another good cabin.
Down Jim Hill's main
this
line.
One's got brooms,
hallelujah,
another guest book. It's got another sink with running water.
Bum again.
For washing dishes. Oh, look at all those more dishes. Look at the coffee cup.
Again. I went
it's really
nice. And I asked for some
transactions
bread.
Of the American Institute of Mining and Metallurgical Engineers. Volume 190, 1951.
Doing lighter?
Wow.
Give us a handout to revive us again.
Alright, these are some pictographs that we found up here in Panamint City. Now, if these are authentic, they have to be fairly recent because you can see, for instance, cows. Cows they weren't around this area until the settlers came in. Horses, for the same reason. So I'd say this is probably just a few hundred years old. And also pictographs are also more recent than petroglyphs.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because they actually painted these on there.
Looks like they just had chalk that they bought at KB toy stores. I'm just kidding.
Oh, it's all zoomed in too.
Kneel down on one knee.
Happened an hour ago, way down in this tunnel of coal. The gas caught fire from somebody's lamp, and the miners are choking in smoke. Goodbye to Dickie and honey, goodbye to the wife that I love. A lot of these men not coming home tonight when the work whistle blows. Dear sisters and brothers, goodbye. Dear mother and father, goodbye. My fingers are...
Come on, let's do it, guys. Come on.
Why?
Because it's fun.
Doesn't every mine shaft end the same?
Shh.
Either a brick or a wall. It's all that water.
Can't really see. Move to the side. Move against the walls. There you go. You see that little white light? That is how far the entrance is.